This is Sherman and Bill Allen, and we are at SlideAway Studios, Silent, and we are recording a tribute album of Bugs Henderson. Tell me a little bit about why, what's the connection, all that.
Sure. Bugs Henderson, you know, in Texas, he truly is a legend. I think he's the best blues guitarist of his generation. He passed away of liver cancer a couple of years ago. And so he's widely known in guitar circles as a blistering virtuoso player. But what was easy to overlook was his great songwriting. So we've pulled together some of the best musicians in Texas and Los Angeles to record 18 and counting of Bugs' compositions. And tonight we're here with Lou Diamond Phillips and Steve Veroni from the Heartbreakers, and Kenny Lee Lewis from Steve Miller Band, and Jimmy Vivino from Everything, Bill Mumy, and Slim is playing harp on this one, and Lou Diamond Phillips is singing it, so that's what we're cutting tonight, and it's been 18 sessions with that kind of roster. It's been absolutely a dream come true, and it's called King of Clubs. It's a tribute to Bugs Henderson.
Bill, tell me a little bit about some of the other players that have been coming through the studio to do this.
A lot of top LA session guys. We've had Sugar Ray Rayford come in. We've had Steve Lukather from Toto fame, Orion Thea, who was in the Michael Jackson This Is It concert movie. Let's see, Teresa James we've had.
Kenny Aronoff.
Kenny Aronoff. Man, it's just, the list goes on and on. And
Government Mule guys. Just as soon as we put out the word of what we were doing, it's been hard to... We're 2 years trying to close this thing down because people keep showing up going, what am I, chopped liver? I want to be on this thing too. And they're so great, and we want them on. Yeah. That it's, you know, 2 years of the best of the best. And in Texas too, don't forget them. Jimmy Wallace out there has recorded a lot of Bugs' ex-sidemen, too numerous to mention, but a couple would be Bobby Chitwood, Linda Waring, Mike Gage. These are guys that are gods in Texas, not necessarily known out here, but that's changing.
Now, Bill, I know you have, you've known Bugs for a long time. Tell me a little bit about that.
Actually, I got to know Bugs after I moved to California. I was such a fan when I lived in Texas, but after I left Sherman, became friends with him. So it was through that association that I became friendly with the family, and they just embraced me as one of their own very early on, and Sherman also. They were just good Texas folk. And we had this kind of LA-Texas connection where they would come stay with us, and we'd help them book gigs and vice versa. So we had a real nice family atmosphere going. And about 2.5 years ago, Bugs announced that he had liver cancer and stood in my kitchen and told me that he's about to get into chemotherapy, and within 6 months he was gone. It was just that quick. So in the meantime, we had already had this tribute album that he was to play on.
Yeah, I was going to raise dough for medical bills and stuff. Mm-hmm. And he wanted to be part of it. He didn't live long enough to see it even really get kicked off.
Oh. So the production had legs, and now we're wrapping it up 2 years later, and we've come up with just a gem of a record that I'm really excited to share.
Oh, you know who's on it that I can't not mention is Ray Wiley Hubbard, one of the great songwriters in the world. And when I first really started hanging out with Bugs, he and Ray were a duet, so I spent a lot of time on a tour bus with them in the 80s, and I get to play guitar on a song with Ray Hubbard, and I'm just over the moon about it. It's one of the high points of my life.
So how you feeling as you're coming to a close on the album?
It's very emotional. This has been a wonderful ride, and I felt like Bugs has been with us in the studio the whole time. So it's been an experience that I thought, well, we're going to raise some money for Bugs and some awareness, and this is my gift to him. Well, it's completely the opposite. This has been his
truly
gift to us, you know, and helping us put this together. I feel it. So I think the people will too once they hear it.
And you know what? You know, we've recorded 18 of his songs, and we probably listened to three times that many to cull the ones that we settled on. And so right in this room, there's been so much playback of his voice and his guitar playing so that we could learn the tunes. And so it's just been 1,000 hours of listening to him in the room. And, you know, that energy is real. You know, we're talking about really a family member to Bill and me, and to some of the cats that have played on it, that this room's become like really the Bugs room to me. It's kind of hard to talk about, but that's what's going on here.
No. Yeah. Well, I'm here with Sherman and Bill Allen, and they're producing the tribute album of Bugs Henderson with Chuck as well.
King of Clubs.
King of Clubs.
So you're trying to come up with a name, and I remembered overhearing Bugs. He was a very funny, fast kind of talking guy, and I heard him on the phone, "Hey, it's me, it's Bugs, the Sultan of the Strings, King of Clubs." And so he was also known to play.
You remembered that, didn't you?
Yeah, I wrote that down. 30 years later, now we got a use for it.
That's great. All right, let's chat with Kelly Z. And again, I'm here with Bill and Sherman Allen.
Thanks, darling.